she began the day in a relatively casual ensemble, but Meghan was back to her signature glamour for her final engagement in Morocco on Monday. The Duchess of Sussex switched her jeans and t-shirt combo for an elegant pleated black dress and a recycled cream jacket from Babaton, which she had previously worn to watch Harry at the polo last year. The heavily pregnant mother finished her look with a pair of Manolo Blahnik slingbacks, which she was spotted wearing yesterday, and a pair of statement gold earrings by Gaspijou. Harry too had changed, swapping his chinos and puffer jacket for a sand-colored suit as he joined Meghan for a visit to the Social Entrepreneurs event and market in the Andalusian Gardens. The Duke and Duchess will hear about youth empowerment in Morocco from a number of young social entrepreneurs. She and Harry arrived hand in hand at their third engagement on Monday, having put on a very tactile display throughout the day. The parents-to-be were seen admiring the traditional Moroccan arts and crafts on display in the walled public garden amid exotic plants, flowers and fruit trees. During the visit, the Duke of Sussex called for more pressure to be put on big companies to end the manufacture of single-use plastic bottles. Highlighting the importance of recycling, he said they were not doing enough to reduce the amount of plastic waste. The parents-to-be were seen admiring the traditional Moroccan arts and crafts on display in the walled public garden amid exotic plants, flowers and fruit trees. During the visit, the Duke of Sussex called for more pressure to be put on big companies to end the manufacture of single-use plastic bottles. Highlighting the importance of recycling, he said they were not doing enough to reduce the amount of plastic waste. Talking to another business which recycles the waste from olive oil production into cosmetics, the Duchess opened a jar of black Moroccan soap and said, "Oh, it smells incredible." She added, "Congratulations, very impressive." Looking at a stand which featured wallets and shoes made from cured fish skin, the Duchess told PhD student Noel Alawi, "It's very clever." Meghan asked what happened when it got wet, but she replied, "It's waterproof." Harry congratulated her on moving away from snakeskin and crocodile skin. Meghan said, "It's really amazing not to use exotics like that, and instead use something sustainable that would otherwise go to waste. But they still have a fashionable impact." The couple also met the founders of Zine, a luxury shoe brand employing women from the poor parts of Morocco. Its shoes sell for between £400 and £600. Zineb Brightel said the Duchess admired a pair of shoes called El Nido made from raffia with a distinctive round heel. She said, "Wow, this is a kick-ass heel." As they left the museum, they passed a stray cat which Harry paused to point out. Outside, the couple were shown an array of craft stands, including ornate wooden boxes carved by Mustafa Delsh. He gave the Duchess a necklace of cedar wood balls, and gave Harry what he called a magic box made from sandalwood, which Harry at first tried to refuse. Twisting the lid reveals four hidden compartments. "It is sandalwood, it is a good smell." Driss Seki gave them an ornate handmade bronze platter, and showed them a photograph of him giving Prince Charles a box when he visited Fez in 2011. The couple also left with a leather pouf, possibly for their new home at Frogmore Cottage, Windsor. The couple will then travel to Rabat, where they will meet King Mohammed VI and stay the night privately in Rabat, before flying back to London tomorrow. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex vowed to return to Morocco with their baby after sampling a selection of classic national dishes on Monday. Harry and Meghan took up the offer of a meal for the whole family from top chef Mo Hafidou, who hosts the North African nation's version of MasterChef. He told the couple, "I hope to cook for you next time," as they joined him for a cookery demonstration with underprivileged children in the capital Rabat. He is already a fan of the chef's work, having visited his famous Darmoha restaurant on a secret visit to Marrakesh just before the royal wedding, in April 2018. Although Moha would not be drawn on the secret trip, he admitted with a smile, he, Harry, loves pasta, the sweet and savory, and kefta. During their visit to the colorful Villa des Ambassadeurs, a privately owned guest house set up with temporary cooking stations, the royal couple sampled an array of fragrant and spicy dishes, including the pigeon pasta Harry is so fond of. And while Meghan is known to be an ethical and healthy eater, she is not vegetarian, also tucking into the meaty treat and declaring it delicious. The pigeon pasta, similar to a phyllo pie filled with the game, is thought to be what the prince dined on when he first visited Moha's restaurant last year and is said to have been very taken with them. The Duchess replied, "The whole family next time." The chef said, "You come with your baby to Marrakesh next time," referring to the fact that the prince visited his restaurant in the city back in 2018. "We would love to," said Meghan. "Come with your baby and I will cook for all three," he told Harry as he joined them. The Duke, clearly inspired by the delicious spread he had sampled, replied, "We will cook for you." They arrived at the ornately decorated residence to a traditional welcome of dates and milk, which both royals eagerly sampled. Inside they walked around the stations and chatted to the young cooks, aged between 9 and 18, stopping to try mince and onion pastries, Harry, and Harira, a spicy chickpea soup, both. Chef Moha handed them each a decorated ceramic bowl to try and they each took a sip. "C'est délicieux," said Meghan in French. "What's in it?" asked Harry, before joking, "It's a secret recipe." One child said something in Arabic to the chef, who turned to the Duke and said, "He finds you a very good person." "He is a good person," smiled the Duchess, putting an affectionate hand on her husband's arm. The children are cared for by three different charities, including HADAF, an organization which employs young people with Down syndrome, L'Association Musulmane de Bienfaisance and the Lala Miriam Center, founded by King Mohammed VI's sister. Also on the menu, Moroccan pancakes with honey and almond butter, a recipe by Shireen Mala, taken from the Grendel cookbook which the Duchess helped to produce. The dish features in Together, Our Community Cookbook, which became a bestseller after Meghan launched it on a visit the Al-Manar Cultural Center, which is at the heart of the community devastated by the Grenfell Tower fire. The mother-to-be was seen putting on a tactile display with Prince Harry as the couple shared the sweet treat with a giggling Meghan unable to take her hands off her husband. Handed a pancake covered in amlu, a blend of almond butter, argan oil and honey, Harry took a huge mouthful. "Big bite," laughed Meghan. "Bit late now," replied her husband. Meghan developed the Together cookbook idea over a series of earlier private visits where she cooked with the women of the Hub community kitchen there. Sales of the book have allowed them to refurbish the facilities and expand their work in providing freshly prepared food for those displaced by the tragedy as well as other community groups. Earlier this morning, the Duchess of Sussex claimed she felt camera shy sometimes as the Duke and Duchess of Sussex began their second day in Morocco with a visit to the Moroccan Royal Federation of Equestrian Sports. The couple were there to learn more about the country's developing program of equine therapy for children with special needs, funded by King Mohammed, who Harry and Meghan will have an audience with later today. The couple watched a grooming session with three Shetland ponies, Caramel, a Palomino, Xena, a Piebald and Molly, a black pony, with some of the children who have benefited from the equine-assisted therapy, or equitherapy, program, in one of the club's outdoor manages. "Has anyone got any carrots?" joked Harry, noticing that Molly was shaking. "She's a bit nervous, this one," he said. Meghan joked, "Well, we all get a little camera shy, I understand." Meghan cut a casual figure in jeans and a Breton t-shirt on her final morning in Morocco. The mother-to-be, who has been seen in a variety of brand new designer pieces of late, chose to recycle an old jacket today. She paired her ensemble with a 185-pound khaki anorak by J. Crew that she has previously been pictured wearing during the early days of her relationship with Harry and while she was still living in Toronto. Meghan wore her brunette locks in a sleek ponytail as she and Harry arrived hand in hand at the stables. And while she certainly opted for a more dressed-down look this morning, the Duchess added a little glamour to her ensemble in the form of a pair of heeled Stuart Weitzman ankle boots. The couple arrived to an unusual welcome committee in the form of the horses, who poked their heads out of their stables upon their arrival. Animal lover Meghan was eager to say hello with she and Harry seen petting the horses ahead of their tour of the Equine Center. They were also introduced to Louis Browski, from Holland, the founder of the center social caryatin sale, an organization working with mentally and physically disabled young people. Mr. Browski, who has trained horses for more than 30 years, is one of the country's leading figures in equine therapy. "It was a challenge," he told them. "I started with one child, but now 16 years later we have 100 children. My aim is for all disabled children to be fully integrated into Moroccan society. That is just so important, and this is just a gorgeous space you have here," said Meghan, before being introduced to some of the young people Mr. Browski brings to ride at the club. Harry and Meghan met Ikram, 20, who has Down syndrome, and began riding at the club a month ago. Speaking through a translator, she told them, "I love the connection with the horses. It already makes me feel relaxed and more confident. And I like being outside, with nature." Meghan told her, "Wow, you're very impressive. What an accomplished lady. I imagine it's so therapeutic as well as meditative." Next, the couple were introduced to Driss, 24, who told them how his youth had involved violence and drugs but how the equine therapy has helped him regain confidence and made him feel calmer. Driss now has a job with the Center Social Cariat and helps disadvantaged and disabled children develop their skills and learn how to ride. Harry, who grew up riding and still plays polo, told him, "It's amazing what you can do here. For someone like you, who must have lost so much trust in all sorts of people around you growing up, you've been able to put your trust in horses. The trust between us and horses, it's a very special thing. I'm missing my old horses." Harry and Meghan also watched a riding demonstration in another outdoor manege, with three autistic children riding ponies, while one of the equine therapists explained how they start the children with grooming ponies before gradually building them up to ride. "It's a wonderful, holistic approach," said Meghan. Asking them where they all from each day to work, Meghan said, "I imagine no matter where you all come from, it's so worth it. It's amazing what you all do here. Really impressive." Harry told them, "You've got the space, the horses, and the King's support. Keep up the amazing work. It would be wonderful to see more of this across Morocco." The couple also met with young people from disadvantaged backgrounds who have benefited from the programs at the center, together with mental health charity and individuals involved. Meghan reverted back to her French again, wishing them bonne journée. The equine therapy program relies on several organizations, including SAREC, the Royal Company for the Encouragement of Horses, CELA, a mental health charity supporting vulnerable communities, and SPANA, the Society for the Protection of Animals and Nature. Horse riding for children with special needs has been shown to improve children's communication skills, boost their confidence, and help them build relationships. Sunday night saw Meghan pull out all the stops in a sweeping caftan-inspired Dior gown as she joined husband Prince Harry for a reception at the British ambassador's residence in Morocco. Mother-to-be Meghan looked radiant in the custom crystal-embellished cream number, which she teamed with metallic heels, a favorite pair of £6,950 diamond earrings, and a satin clutch, also by Dior. The royal couple, who are on a three-day tour of the North African country, spent the evening mingling with captains of industry, military officers, disabled athletes, and young business leaders. Issuing a clarion call to feminists, Meghan told a group of female executives and entrepreneurs that women around the world need to push the boundaries to advance their cause. "Women have to challenge everywhere in the world," she said. The evening event was hosted by British Ambassador Thomas Riley and his wife Leah at their official residence in the capital of Rabat, a city which has been rocked by riots in recent days. The appearance rounded off a busy second day of engagements, which saw Harry, 34, and Meghan travel to the town of Annecy in the foothills of the Atlas Mountains to visit a secondary school and meet pupils. The Duchess, who impressed by speaking in French, also took part in a traditional henna ceremony,